All right, so now that we have talked about the browser support, the terminology, and so on, you're now ready to actually dive into code and create your very first grid container. Now, before you do that, go ahead and check out the lecture resources for this lecture and download the zip archive. You can unpack that, and then in Atom and also in Sublime Text, you can simply go to File and then Open Folder to open up the whole folder so that you have in your sidebar all the files from this template that I provided for you. Now, if this sidebar doesn't show up, then also in Sublime Text as well as Atom, it's the same key combination. You can press Ctrl KB to make it disappear or appear again. All right, and once you have this done, then you can check out this template here, and I'm going to guide you through this very quickly. So first of all, there's the index.html file, just a very simple HTML5 template that you can use to add new elements down here. And if you want to work with this offline, you can also remove this font import here. Then in the base CSS file from the CSS directory here, you have some basic styles that you don't really need to touch. You don't need to make any modifications here. What's important is that down here, there's also some code that actually modifies elements with a class of grid. And we're going to use that very much in this course. And this just applies some nice styles to all the grid items in such a container so that they just look a bit nicer. But it's important to notice that they don't actually use any CSS grid specification properties, so there's nothing actually that uses or makes this a grid. So that's still what you're going to have to do in this course. It just applies some nice styles to the child elements. And then in the main CSS file here, this is where you can put your code. And it's also where I'm going to show you what CSS properties there are in the CSS grid specification. So I'm going to use the exact same template here that you're also going to use so that you can follow along nicely. So with this quick walkthrough done, we can actually now go back to our index.html file. And then inside here, I'm going to again use the emmet plugin that I talked about briefly before to generate a div with a class of grid. And then inside this, I'm going to create another div. And I'm going to do that, let's say, 6 times. And in each of those, I'm actually going to include the word item and then the number. And now when I hit Ctrl E, then emmet is going to go ahead and expand this to this HTML markup. So I have now a class grid on my div, and I have 6 grid items in there. So this is what I want to work with in this lecture. And we can actually go ahead and take a look at this in the browser. So I'm now going to go ahead and open up Firefox. All right, so now I have my code editor and Firefox here side by side. And I'm currently using Firefox version 53. Now you can see that with this simple container here, and remember that we haven't actually used any CSS grid specification yet. So there's no code in here. And in the base CSS, there are also, well, no code that really uses CSS grids. So by default at the moment, the grid container here is just going to use display block. And then of course, each of the child items here is going to be stacked above each other. So now let's go ahead and say in our main CSS, we're going to target that grid container. And then all you have to do is say display grid. And that's going to make this a grid container as we discussed. And now if I go into Firefox here and say inspect element, then I can go down here and click on our grid. And then here, this is again the nice developer plugin here in Firefox, where you can see that there are actually dotted lines here. I'm not sure if you can see this in the video, but you can see that we have now 6 rows in our grid container. And in this case, it doesn't look different than just having a display block, but it's still very different because you could do lots of different things with this now because it is a grid container, and we're going to talk about this in the coming lectures. But for now, this is just a grid container, and we haven't actually specified explicitly how many rows or columns this should have. So by default, every grid item in this container is going to, well, automatically make the grid container create a new row so that each of the items is actually going to span the whole width of the container. So now, of course, the next thing we want to do is define how many rows and columns this grid should actually have. And that's exactly what we're going to do in the next lecture.